Don't believe the hype, it's a sequel. As an equal, can I get this through to you? My 98 booming with a trunk of funk. All the jealous punks can't stop the dunk. Coming from the school of hard knocks, some perpetrate and drink Clorox. Attack the black because I know they lack. 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 Exact the cold facts and still they try to Xerox. The leader of the new school, uncool. Never played the fool, just made the rule. Remember there's a need to get alarm. Again I said I was a time bomb. They can't come on and play me in prime time, cause I know the time, plus I'm getting mine. I get on the mix late in the night. They know I'm living right, so here goes the mic sight. Before I let it go, don't rush me. I see their tape recorder and I grab it.
No, you can't have it back, silly rabbit.
I'm going to my media assassin, Harry Allen. I gotta ask him.
Now here's what I want you all to do for me.
That's why even in fighting, even in the intelligence agency, sometimes the best assassin's a woman. That's why even in fighting, even in the intelligence agency, sometimes the best assassin's a woman.
I want to start a fight!
That's my sister Simone.
Before we even get into this, you have to realize that everything that's given to me is given to me at the proper time. And when I look at her video count, 433, it tells me that my spirit guides, aka the ETs, wanted me to know that she's part of the Ashtar Command. When I asked this woman right here, her name is the Gen Rogue, she straight up told me that Freelee was Ashtar Command. There's so many things I can say about these two. The most common thing people agree with me about that I talk to on Skype is that they don't see the connection between these two. They all say that Harley is like a guy who is disgusting and not attractive, and I completely agree as far as I don't see the connection with these two. It's never added up. That's the first red flag. Second red flag for me is that I've always said that Harley looks like a demon, and I always said that because I thought he was malnourished, but turns out he's just straight up a demon, and he always has those like demonic eyes, like he's gonna attack, and I always thought that was because of, once again, malnourishment, but he's just a straight up demon, and you know, he's always like flying, doing business trips and all that, and you know what I mean, flying all around, business trips, going places. Now, if she was really human, she would have kicked him to the curb and gone to LA and got on TV like fully raw Christina is trying to do, which is another cyborg. The most important thing with these two is that they're pushing Agenda 21, and I remember a long time ago where she was pretending to not know what chemtrails are. So then some time passes by and I decide to follow Freelee on Google+, and then yesterday I'm just bored out of my mind and I go to the Alex Jones channel, and I can't help but notice that she's subscribed to him, because when you're following someone on Google Plus and you go to someone else's channel, it tells you if they're also, if any of your people in your circle are subscribed as well. And she, Freelee the Banana Girl, is subscribed to Alex Jones. And the timing on this is perfect. Like I said, she has 433 videos. And the timing on this is crazy. And like I said, I straight up asked the Jen Rogue who stole my penis, and she said that Freelee is Ashtar Command. And this just goes to show you that if you're in life, if you're anything spectacular, you're either an alien or a messiah seed. There's really... humans, real humans, just don't do anything spectacular, and they're just there to work the jobs. Work the jobs. And she's only doing all this because she's on a mission, and she wouldn't do it otherwise. It's all Agenda 21, which is really Agenda 2-in-1. 2-in-1 meaning two genders in one, which brings up the topic of female mixed martial arts, which is male energy in a female body. Oh, Yolanda, you are one of the prettiest cyborgs there ever lived. This woman has been with me, chatting with me on Skype since 2012. She never said anything of substance. She always just kept typing sweet nothings and more sweet nothings, ad infinitum, ad nausea. And she has driven me wild with lust with her beautiful body. And of course, she never really wanted anything to do with me. It was just her job to talk with me and shoot the breeze. And it's funny how all these beautiful blonde Borgs all look like they came off the same assembly line. Beach Bum, Captain Kitty Bum Report, and Yolanda Bailey, they all look exactly alike. And this dog you see right here lives in Chester, England. That's where all the rich people live. Now this one right here, she's never formally introduced herself, but she's another one of those people on Google Plus who followed me and has yet to say hi because she has bad manners. But once again, she looks like a Yolanda clone. Now here's the one our favorite cyborg, Ald Kendall, said would take care of my needs. She's self-proclaimed Rothschild, which I believe travels all over the world just like Harley does. She's got a draconian, a master draconian by the name of Tribune Riddlemeyer following her on Google Plus, and one day this woman all of a sudden decides to follow me on Google Plus and once again never say hello. And the same draconian following her is following me. So I like her better than Iggy Azalea already. I can tell we're going to have last but not least, how could we forget Iggy Azalea, my supposed future wife, who I will try to avoid at all costs because I'm not a fan of idiocracy music or wide hips. But as you can see here, once again, 533. 33s never lie, do they? Her real name is Amethyst, and you know what, I really don't even want her, and how the hell am I supposed to satisfy a woman with wide hips? Her current boyfriend's name is Swaggy P, as in Swaggy Penis, as in a big penis, and I have a tiny Neanderthal cock, so I don't see how I could ever satisfy this woman. I mean, I wasn't meant to be with a woman who had wide hips. I'm just a chimpanzee. This guy is not Ashtar Command. I just thought I'd throw this asshole in here. And Ald Kendall sent me this guy. His name is Michael Holding, the Whispering Death. He's a famous cricket player, and he got the nickname Whispering Death because he's killed lots of people in Buckingham Palace and various other places. So I just thought I'd throw this asshole in here. And you can clearly tell by his eyes that he's a sociopath, so, yep.
The high.